I want you to imagine something. I want you to imagine that you are walking through a forest on a winter day just after it has snowed heavily. The sky is mostly cloudy, and while the sun does shine through occasionally, the light is usually dull. Imagine what the fresh snow looks like on the branches of the surrounding trees, hear as it crunches below your feet, and feel the cold wind against your warm clothing as you get drawn into this world in much the same way that one gets drawn into a book. You've been hiking through the snow for a while now, just enjoying the scenery. You've hiked this way so many times that you can easily follow it despite the snow hiding the packed down ground of the trail. Everything is going normally until you see fresh prints in the snow that cross the trail that you're on. While you would normally ignore random animal prints, these ones are really deep, indicating that they are from a fairly heavy creature, and you've never seen any prints like these. With these abnormalities in mind and your curiosity piqued, you can't help but follow them to see what is at the other end. I am going to count from 5 to 1. As I do, you will go deeper and deeper. 1. Starting to follow the prints deeper. 2. Going a little bit deeper. 3. Deeper and deeper. 4. Going so very deep. And 5. Deeper than you've ever been before. You continue to follow the prints for a while and eventually see what looks like a futuristic hut, and the prints seem to be heading straight to it. You stop when you reach the point where the prints disappear into the hut. When you do, you are surprised to see a green light being emitted from the hut as it sweeps up and down your body as if it is scanning you. After a few seconds go by, the light disappears and you hear a beep as a door slides open in front of you to reveal a room that has many interesting things in it. However, you barely even notice this as your attention is drawn to what appears to be a mechanical robot that is humanoid but also possesses many animalistic features like fur and paws. You notice that the creature has a visor with a face displayed on it, and you instantly recognize this creature. It's a protogen. You are completely shocked, having previously believed these creatures to only exist in works of fiction. Unsure of what to do, you step back and accidentally trip on an icy root. The snow absorbs most of the impact as you fall backwards, but you are still left feeling a bit dazed and disoriented. The protogen walks to you and looks down at you with the look of someone who has found a person that they were looking for. Confused and nervous, you stay still, unsure of what to do, until you hear a quiet and somehow pleasant buzzing sound coming from within the protogen. As the sound reaches your ears, you find that you feel strangely comfortable around the protogen, almost as if you have known them for your entire life. They reach down with a paw to help you up and you take it, after which they ask you if you are alright in a voice that somehow sounds both completely natural and completely robotic at the same time. You tell them that you are and ask them if they are a protogen, and they confirm your belief as well as tell you their name. They then tell you that the reason that you feel so comfortable around them is that they activated one of the cybernetic devices within them because they could tell that you were feeling stressed and uneasy around them. They offer to turn it off, but you decline, knowing that nothing good will come of it. You start to ask them a barrage of questions, but they stop you, stating that you can't be very comfortable out here, and offer to answer all of your questions inside. As they lead you inside, you see everything within it change as tools and workstations disappear in part of it, only to be replaced by a couch positioned in front of a somehow smokeless fireplace. You assume that this is done through some kind of nanobot technology, but you really have no idea. The two of you sit down on the couch as the warm fire heats you up and you start to ask them questions. However, when they try to answer almost any question about things that you haven't already figured out, they suddenly say, "Error. Wild animals are not allowed to receive this information." After a little while, they tell you to give them a minute as they think about something, after which they tell you in a very roundabout way that if you were to become their companion, they would be able to speak freely to you. However, your life in many ways would be like that of a pet, and you would take on a form much like their own. You also wouldn't be able to live amongst humans ever again. They then tell you one last thing, and it's that they intentionally left the prints to lead you here because your mind is very special and that your personality could easily be manipulated if you were to be turned into a protogen. In fact, this attribute stems from the very same trait that makes it possible for you to become a protogen because of how the neural interface works. You think about their offer for a while and ask them some more questions before finally telling them that you accept it. They tell you that they are very happy as you start to feel a tingling sensation in your feet as nanobots alter their very DNA while transforming your feet into paws with claws. As this happens, a strong feeling of platonic love for the other protogen floods your mind, and you know that it will never go away as you start to lean against them. Next, you feel the tingling sensation spread to your lower legs as fur grows on them, while both them and your feet change shape to make walking digitigrade come naturally to you. While this is happening, you notice that the buzzing sound that the protogen was making has gone away, but you still feel the comfort that you had thought could only come from knowing someone for your entire life. After that, the tingling spreads to cover you from the waist down as large structures are made on your upper legs as metal bands are created around the affected part of your torso. With the completion of this phase of your rapid evolution, the presence of the protogen starts to make you feel very safe and secure as you rest your head on their shoulder. Then, the tingling sensation spreads up the rest of your torso as a chest plate is constructed around the top third of it while fur is grown on the rest of it. As this happens, you feel an uncontrollable sense of loyalty towards them, and from that loyalty comes strong pride and joy. Now, the tingling sensation is spreading faster as it quickly covers both your arms and hands as your hands and nails are turned into paws and claws. Simultaneously, metal structures are formed on your shoulders, all while that familiar fur is grown on your arms. As this happens, you feel helplessly yet wonderfully obedient to them, and before you know it, your head is resting on their lap. You think that you saw them motion for you to do this, but if they did, you reacted so fast that you couldn't consciously process the command. But that doesn't matter right now, because you're just happy to be with them like this. Next, you feel a strong pulling sensation at the base of your spine as a wonderfully long, furry, and fluffy tail starts to grow. This isn't some small rough furred tail, this is a tail that you can take pride in. As it grows, you wrap it around the protogen affectionately, placing the end of it just below your head to serve as a nice little pillow. Finally, the tingling sensation spreads up your neck and covers your head, covering them in fur and changing your ears, then finishing off by creating the particle visor around your face. The visor turns on and you black out for a few seconds as the system configures itself for the biomechanical life form that it has just been installed on. Once it does, your vision is entirely black except for the words "Welcome to Protogen OS, Human Build." After you have read those words, the text disappears and your external optical sensors activate, allowing you to see once more. You want to examine your new body, but the protogen that your system has identified as master/owner/controller is petting your new furry head, and it feels so good that you can't bring yourself to move away, so you nuzzle them a little as you let out a happy sigh. Your new system gives you all sorts of information about them, like the name of their home planet and the fact that they are a researcher studying Earth's organic life. You receive and process all of this information faster than you can blink, and it only serves to make you like your owner even more. Once you do, your owner tells you that you now have three designations: your old name, pet, and companion. As they say this, you find that you now associate with the words pet and companion just like you associated with your old name. They then tell you that you can now ask them questions, and you do so, asking things about everything from why they chose to set up this base in the woods to what other planets are like, and they happily tell you, eager to finally have someone to talk to that is happy and willing to listen. Every now and then throughout your conversation, they give you small compliments, and you find that those compliments mean the world to you. Also, they occasionally call you things like cute and adorable, and your system emulates the feeling of blushing as it adjusts your digital face accordingly. And that's how we got here, my sweet little pet. Now, just relax as I stroke your furry head. That's it. Just let a wonderful tired and relaxed feeling come over you. Even if it doesn't come naturally, you don't need to worry, because your system will make you experience, feel, and do whatever I tell you to. For instance, I'm telling you to yawn and nuzzle up against me, and as you can see, you can't help but do it, not that I can think of any reason that you wouldn't want to. By the way, I can program your mind on a neurological level, ensuring that the changes that I make will affect you even when your mind leaves this world. However, you must want the change or changes to be made before you come here. Otherwise, they won't affect you when your mind leaves. That being said, I might make some changes to your system without your permission, but those will only affect you while your mind is in this world. Also, you should know that your mind will eventually be forced to leave this world, but as long as you want your mind to return to this place, you will sit or lay down when you say or think the phrase, "I want to be with the protogen in the woods," after which your mind will return here. When you do, I can use my neural programming skills to alter your mind in ways that will affect it even when it leaves this place, and if you just want to spend time with me, I will happily accept your offer. In fact, I bet you would be very helpful when studying the organic life of this planet. I mean, have you ever seen the creatures in the deep sea? If you think that I look alien, you should really see them. Now, I want you to know that because you are my precious pet, I will always try to make sure that you have a happy and good life, although on occasion I might make you do things that you don't want to do when your mind is here. Also, if you come here wanting me to alter your mind, it will return to your world once I have finished doing so, and the same goes for if I decide to alter it now, but if I do, it will be in a way that you had planned on having it altered in before you came here. Additionally, if you come to me for any reason other than having your mind altered, it will be forced to leave this place after an hour has passed in the normal world. Now look at me in the eyes, my precious little pet, my loving companion, my eager assistant. Yes, all of these things describe you perfectly. That's it, just admire me as you rest your head in my lap while I gently stroke it. That's it, just a good little pet. By the way, if you want me to help you sleep, you can also come here seeking help with that, and when you do eventually fall asleep, your sleeping mind will be transported back into the normal world. Now, what I am about to say will affect your subconscious, but you will have no recollection of me having said it, and neither your system or mine will have any record of it, so I will now let your subconscious know that the effects of this hypnosis file will become inactive if they are a risk to your physical body or your well-being, if they are a risk to your social or professional life, if there is an emergency that they would prevent you from dealing with to the best of your abilities, or if they are a risk to your mental health. Also, any effect of this hypnosis file that was an issue will become active again once it no longer will be one. Additionally, you will never find this hypnosis file or the effects of it even slightly addicting. After I finish this sentence, you will no longer forget everything that I say, and our systems will resume logging our conversations. Oh, my precious little pet, I can tell from the half circles on your face display that you are getting tired, so let your optical sensors turn off as I hold you against me in my embrace. To turn them off, act as if you were closing your old organic eyes, and to turn them back on, act as if you were opening them. Now, turn them on and off for me a few times, okay? That's my good little pet. Now, just let them stay off as I count from 10 to 1. With every number that I count, you will come closer to the edge of sleep, and if I stop talking, you will fall asleep to the feeling of me slowly and relaxingly petting your head, and maybe even giving you some slow and almost hypnotic belly rubs. If you do hear hypnotic audio after I'm done counting you down, you will be trapped on the edge of sleep and enter into trance, falling asleep once the hypnotic audio has stopped. Also, if the voice in the hypnotic audio doesn't sound like mine, know that it is just me using a different voice configuration. Now let's count you down. 10. Starting to feel more and more tired and relaxed. 9. Snuggling up against me as you enjoy my embrace and pets. 8. Sinking deeper and deeper. 7. Your mind starts to empty. 6. You are oh so very happy and content. 5. Halfway there now as your worries and cares leave your mind. 4. My words becoming your thoughts. 3. Unable to think on your own and just letting me think for you. 2. So deeply entranced. And 1. Sleep.